Good morning to all. Welcome to our next class. Then today we are discuss about the topic utility approach. Then yesterday we learn about that relationship between total utility and marginal utility. So we know that what do you mean by the total utility? Total utility is the sum total of the marginal utility and the marginal one related to the additional unit. So the marginal utility is the ratio of change in total utility upon change in quantity. Now we discuss about the law of Deminsing marginal utility. What do you mean by the law of Deminsing marginal utility? Define it with the help of table and diagrams. Then law of Deminsing marginal utility states that as the consumer consumes the standard unit of the commodities continuously, then consumption of every additional unit, these must be declined. It means, for example, the consumer consumes any one commodities continuously, then as he consumes the additional unit of these commodities, then consumption starts decreasing. It means uska ek se dusri par, dusri se tisri par, the consumption starts decreasing. Then these are also based on the some assumptions. And the assumptions, it means the sum factors are constant. Then on this basis, these law can be applied. So the assumption says the standard unit of the commodities, standard units, it means the consumer consumes standard unit of the commodities. Then it means a complete unit. For example, if he consumed the bread, it means it does not mean the bite of the bread, it is related to the complete bread. These are count in the first unit. One unit ke roop mein isko count kiya jayega. Then second assumption is continue consumption. It means when the consumer starts consumes any commodities, then there is a no gap between the consumption. It means the consumption would be continued. So these are the two assumptions on which the law of Deminsing marginal utility based. So these can be defined with the help of the table and diagram. Total utility schedule and marginal utility schedule के द्वारा हम इसको define कर सकते हैं. We know that the quantity, marginal utility and total utility. Quantity defined in terms of units. Utility, which can be, what's the measurement of the utility? These are the utils. It means in the marginal utility and total utility can be measured in terms of utils. So the measurement of utility is utils, which can be measured in terms of numbers. So total utility also measures in terms of utils. So 4, 5 and 6. So we assume that the marginal utility for every additional units, when the consumer consumes, these starts declining. It means the fast foods provides the maximum satisfaction to the consumer. For example, 4 utilities. When he consumes the second unit of the commodities, then these provide less satisfaction than the first unit. It means 3. And when the consumer consumes the third unit of the commodities, then consumption will be decreases in comparison of the second unit. So 0 and minus 1. It means 0 jahan par hai, it shows the maximum satisfaction level of the consumer, And after these, when the consumer starts increase the consumptions, then the consumption level should be negative, right? It means it gives the negative results to the consumers when he continuously consume any commodities. So with the help of the marginal utility, we can find out the total utility. It is the sum total of the marginal utility. 4 plus 3, 7, 7 plus 2, 9, 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 0, 10, 10 minus 1, 9. So these can be shown with the help of a diagram. These show in a systematical way in the previous class. So we define only the, it means these are the total utility curve. These are the maximum point of the total utility and the marginal utility is negatively sloped. So with the help of these curves, we show the law of diminishing marginal utility. It means when the consumer consumes continuously any commodities, the consumption for every additional unit, these must be declined. And these can be shown with the help of the marginal utility. As the commodities are increased, the consumption are increased continuously, the marginal utility curve starts declining. And at the point A, these are equal to zero. And after these, he consumes any commodities, then marginal utility is negative. So these are the law of diminishing marginal utility, and we can also define it with the help of table and diagram also. The next question is differentiate between the cardinal utility and ordinal utility. What's the difference between the cardinal utility and ordinal utility? We have the two chapters of the consumer's equilibrium. First is related to the utility approach, and the second is related to the indifference approach. And these shows the difference between the utility approach and indifference approach. It means, what do you mean by the cardinal utility? The cardinal utility, which can be measured in terms of numbers, right? Which can be measured in terms of quantity or numbers. These are called the cardinal utility. And what do you mean by the ordinal utility? The ordinal utility can be measured in terms of rank also. It means hum isko rank ke roop mein define karte hain. These cannot be measured in numbers or quantity. So these can be measured in terms of numbers. These are called the cardinal utility, and which can be measured in terms of rank. These are called the ordinal utility. For example, the cardinal utility, for example, 10, 12, 14, 9, these are the numbers. So these are included in the cardinal utility. And in the ordinal utility, we can define in terms of numbers. So, for example, increases, decreases, highest, lowest, intelligent. So these are defined, these define the ordinal utility. And the utility approach, which are related to the, it means the utility approach related to the cardinal approach. It means when we measure, yeah, when we evaluate the utility approach, then we include the numbers. It means the consumption can be measured in terms of numbers, but in the real life, the consumption cannot be measured, your satisfaction cannot be measured in terms of numbers, right? So the ordinal utility related to the indifference approach. Indifference approach se related kaun sa hai? Ordinal approach and cardinal approach shows the utility approach and ordinal utility shows the ya approach shows the indifference approach. It means the main difference between the cardinal and ordinal utility. These are the it can be measured in terms of numbers and it can be measured in terms of rank. Right? So that's all for today. For the further classes, connect with our YouTube channel. Thanks and have a nice day.